Guys and ladies, so you have a lot of chemicals and paint and, you know, flammables, technically speaking, in your workshop. So how do you protect your shop? Safety first, right? Not third. So this thingy majiggy up here is automatic fire extinguisher. Technically speaking, what it does is it has an alcohol inside that bulb. It activates at 68 Celsius and 160 or so Fahrenheit. So once it detects the temperature, not it detects the temperature, but once the temperature reaches, you know, over that temperature, it just, the bulb technically expands, the alcohol expands and breaks the bulb, and then it disperses the extinguishing material to all over the place. But yeah, this thing is a 6 kilogram version, 6 kgs. I think it's around 15 pounds or something like that, just the powder inside. Keep in mind, this thing, it took me insane amount of time, and I did overkill the heck out of, you know, all mounting and everything. This thing is very, very heavy. You really want to overkill the whole mounting spots and everything, and you have to be extremely careful where you're mounting it. It's just, as you see that I braced and just wired, and, you know, I even put another extra heavy gauge wire around the thing, just you know, just in case if everything fails, there'll be a wire holding the extinguisher. So this is an automatic extinguisher, just like the normal extinguishers. Just, I have one here. This is a CO2. It's just, as you see that, you just, you know, all you need to do in case of fire, pull the pin, aim, and then push it. But with this one, it's technically, you don't need to do that. It's always active. It's always charged, as long as you see that the gauge is there. That alcohol bulb is going to expand and then, you know, explode, technically speaking, and just like release the fire suppressant agent. Prefer to put the extinguisher as close as possible to the shell or to technically the flammables, as close as possible. Here I have, roughly speaking, 80 centimeters, so like a half a meter, roughly speaking, a little bit more than half a meter. And this thing is really, really gold. I can't just like say that if it is going to work after 5-6 years, because what happens is, this is a powder, it has got powder, and the powder settles to the bottom, and that powder technically starts to become, like, this, as far as I heard from the myths, it starts to become hard. So if you have normal powder extinguishers, once in every 6 months, they suggest, you know, turning them upside down and for that powder to become loose. But it's better than having nothing. So I got like multiple of these ones placed around my shop, placed around my, you know, technically wherever the flammable stuff is. Like, as you see that I got a lot of flammable things and pieces, bits and pieces around, and I really take extreme precautions. This is only one, and on top of it, I got, you know, tons and tons of extinguishers. My tip is, when you are, like, what you can do is, you don't buy new, you go and buy them secondhand from the companies, because they need to be, in Australia, they need to be tagged every, as far as I remember from my memory, every 5 years. And most of the time, companies just give them away for almost for free. You know, they are charged, they are all, you know, weighted up, and they are all ready to go. These are all CO2s. These are like only for, you know, like, I'm not going to go into that. Probably that's another video. But they are like for all this lot, all you need to pay is just like around $20. 20 Australian dollars, and, you know, you can buy the whole lot. And not only that, but they, you know, after you just use them, or even for training purposes or whatever, you just technically can reuse the container. You know, you can just technically use the container itself for, I don't know, like using as a crucible or just using it for like a small air pig or just like a small mini air tank or whatnot. So that's it. I hope that this tip just helps you out. Definitely would like to suggest everyone buying one of these if you have this much flammables, paint and whatnot. And as again, you don't want this gap to be, you know, long, because what happens is that in case of fire, you know, you don't want the fire to grow when you have this much amount of paint and whatnot. Definitely closer, the better. But again, that if you put it close and if you bump to that glass, that will, you know, it will let the whole extinguisher discharge all over the place. So, hope this helps. All the best.